What's up, my internet babes? It's your girl Mia J, and you have tuned into today's video. And in today's video, y'all see the title, but y'all seem to love my cruise content, so here we go. And this video was requested on my YouTube Instagram page, so I'ma do it. Y'all see the title, things you should pack on your cruise. For my people, my beginner cruisers and stuff like that, or just to help anybody out, because it's a lot of things you're not gonna have on your first cruise that you realize you need. So boom, I'm gonna help y'all out. I wrote the things down on my MacBook. I got my MacBook right here. So yeah, stay tuned and let's get into today's video. Okay, y'all. And the time right now is 12:06 a.m. So it's midnight. That's why I'm in the bed. Got my hair wrapped up. All of that stuff. But this camera might keep all over here. So thing number one is an adapter. You need an adapter because in the cabins on a cruise, it only comes with two plugs. So an adapter, you need an adapter that plugs into that one plug and gives you access to like three or more plugs, because you're gonna need plugs. Number two is a waterproof phone case. You know, you wanna cruise, water, pool, you know, things like that. Or it's just, even if you're not getting in water, it's good to have a waterproof phone case. Like, or just to have your phone in around your neck, walking around, you know, it's very convenient. Number three, a lanyard. You need a lanyard for your, you need a lanyard for your sign and seal card. And once you get on the ship, you're going to realize that you need a lanyard. And they sell them right when you walk in, and they're more expensive on the ship. So bring your own lanyard. For y'all that don't know what a sign and seal card is, a sign and seal card, I get this question a lot too. A sign and seal card is basically, your sign and seal card is your best friend, like, during the whole cruise. It's the room, it's your room key, it's your account information, like, things like, basically, you can't walk around a ship with cash and buy things with cash. You swipe that sign and seal card, and it's like, it's an account, as if you'll have a bank account somewhere. It's like that. It's like a mini bank account, basically, and it's your room key all in one. So basically, that's what a sun sale card is. Number four, you need your sun shades. You need your sun shades for obvious reasons. Number five, you need C bands to stop seasickness. So, boom. Majority of people, I'm not gonna say everybody will throw up on their first cruise. Majority of people will throw up on their first cruise. I've did it. Everybody, like majority of people I know, threw up on their first cruise. So have your C bands. Seven, you need your phone chargers, of course. They're more expensive on the ship. Do not forget your phone charger. They'll be probably about $20 on the ship in the gift shop. Number eight, passport, state ID, birth certificate, things like that. So if you do not have a passport, make sure you have your birth certificate and your state ID, or you will not be let on the ship. Number nine, your boarding passes. Also, you will not be let on the ship. 10, luggage tags. You need your luggage tags for obvious reasons. 11, your medicine that you might need. If you're on medicine, birth control, things like that, make sure you don't forget that. Number 10, Apple Watch or just a normal watch. You just need a watch. Like, you know, if you're out on the island, the ship, they say the ship leaves at this time. You need to be back an hour before that time, because the ship will leave. It does not wait on anybody. Number 3, a hat. You need a hat. I won't say you need one, but it's, yes, you would want a hat. Number 4, ladies, do not forget your bonnet. Yes, you need your bonnet. Number 5, water shoes. You need your water shoes. they're just more, you know, convenient. Like, even if you're, like I said about the waterproof phone case, even if you're not getting the pool, the water chutes are a good thing to have, just have handy. Six, you need a lightweight jacket because it gets really, really cold at night, or really, really chilly at nighttime when the sun is not out anymore. 17, you need some formal attire for Captain's Night. Of course, a lot of people don't know about Captain's Night, especially as a first cruiser. So on Captain's Night, it's like a night to celebrate the captain. And excuse me, in the dining room, they have unlimited lobster tails, like unlimited free, you know. Who doesn't love free seafood? Yeah, free. So, but in order to, like, get in there, you need to have on formal attire, like dress, heels, tux, stuff like that. Alexander McQueen, stuff like that. I'm not saying you have to have Alexander McQueen's, but y'all know what I mean. Number 18, a beach bag. So, a beach bag is just good to have on the ship and off the ship for things that you might want to bring with you. So, you won't just have everything in your hand. So, especially off the ship, you need some type of bag, backpack, beach bag, something. Especially for the things that you might buy on the island that you want to bring back on the ship, you need a bag. Because, yeah, the bags, you just need a bag. 19, like I said, 19 is backpack. You need a bag or a backpack, either or, it doesn't really matter. 20, your own cup or refillable bottle. This is priority. Like, my first cruise, I did not have a cup or a refillable bottle, and the little cups that they give are like this short, and you gotta keep getting up, going back. So, and then on your cruise, you're gonna want nothing but something to drink. So when you have your refillable cup or bottle, you can just fill up your ice, put some ice, put some water, or put some ice, put some lemonade. And boom, you good. You good for a good old time. Number 21, a power bank. So basically, when you're not able to be next to a plug, charge that phone, because you need your phone for your pictures and all of that good stuff. 22, canned sodas. So it doesn't have to be soda. Anything canned that comes in a pack. So like, you could bring one pack of soda per passenger. So each passenger can have a pack of soda. You know, it doesn't have to be soda. You know, the breast teas come in the cans. Anything that comes to the can, you can bring it. You can also bring your own snacks. Added that in. 23, Lysol. Because who wouldn't want to disinfect their own room? Like, my mom, we bring Lysol all the time. And it is so handy, like we use it. 24, a hair tie or scrunchie. The wind will have your hair everywhere, literally. At night, or especially if you go on the top deck, you have like long hair or a wig, weave, your hair is gonna be everywhere. Please bring you a scrunchie, or just for excursion wise, or if you get on a boat ride, your hair is gonna be everywhere. Please bring a scrunchie. 25, snorkeling gear. If you're going to snorkel, bring your own gear, because they will charge you to rent snorkeling gear, or they'll charge you to like purchase snorkeling gear. And of course it's higher, so just bring your own snorkeling gear from home if you have it, or buy it in the U.S. And yeah, so that was 25 things that I recommend you bring. If y'all want a part two, let me know. But y'all seem to really love the cruise content. This video was highly requested, so boom, I gave it to y'all, and it's midnight and I just feel like doing this, so hey, why not. Also, just let me know, comment down below or DM me like y'all have been doing on my YouTube Instagram page, and that page will be linked down below. All of my things will be linked down below. I have more cruise videos coming, more cruise content coming, more cruises that are being booked this year coming. Y'all are just gonna come along with me. Y'all know I love the cruise. I could tell y'all all about a cruise all day long. And yeah, thanks for watching. Hope y'all enjoy. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and follow me on all social medias, period.